हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। इन द प्रोसेस इक्विपमेंट डिज़ाइन इन प्रीवियसली वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ एजिटेटर सो लेट्स रिकॉल इट। सो फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस द टाइप्स ऑफ एजिटेटर। सो देयर इज़ अ नंबर ऑफ थ्री टाइप्स: प्रोपेलर्स, पैडल्स एंड टर्बाइन इम्पेलर्स। ओके, सो ईच हैविंग अ डिफरेंट रोल or different constructions in the agitators. Okay, this agitators turbine, that means agitators types, which is different in the flow pattern, current flow patterns, as well as they are having a different flow patterns, which means they are in from that. Some of them is axial flow impellers, and some of them are axial flow reactors, and some of radial flow. Okay, so we see the different types of flow pattern in the buffer tank and without buffer tanks. Okay, and then after we discuss into the turbine agitator, and last we discuss the buffers. So what should be the role play a buffers in the agitated vessel? So buffers is used for the, that means buffers play important role in the agitated vessel. It's that to avoid the vortex formation, and main purpose of the agitation vessel in the in which buffers are used for the remove or avoid the vortex formations. Okay, now the next one is that today's topic is that power required for agitations. Okay, so how much types of power and how can it be defined by power number? So power required for agitation is calculated from power number. Okay, using the power number we are calculating the power requirements for the agitations. So power number is the defined as it is the ratio of drag force acting on a unit of impeller to inertial stress. Power number is the ratio of drag force acting on a unit area of impeller to inertial stress. And the power number NP is given by PGC by rho n cube dA raised to 5. P is the power required for the agitations. Rho is the density for liquid or solution to be agitated. N is the rotational speed for the speed of agitator, is revolution per second. Then dA is the diameter of agitator. Okay, so now it can be given by the power number is the function. We know that it is the function of Reynolds number. So power number is the function of Reynolds number, Froude's number and shape factor. So Reynolds number is the ratio of inertial stress to viscous stress. Reynolds number ne tamare define karu hoy to kai rite kari shako. It is the ratio of inertial stress to viscous stress. So NRE for numbers of Reynolds number for agitations is given by NdA square rho by mu, where mu is the viscosity of the solution, and Froude number Froude number is the ratio of inertial stress to gravitational force acting on unit area of fluid. Froude number is the ratio of inertial stress to gravitational force acting on a unit area of a fluid. So that should be numbers of Froude numbers is equal to n square dA by rho, or n square dA by g, and g is the accelerations of gravity. Okay, and the shape factor are relating linear dimensions of vessels, So for turbine agitator vessel, shape factor S defined as S1 is given by dT by dA, S2 is E by dA, S3 is L by dA, and S4 is W by dA, and S5 is J by dT, and S6 is H by dT. Okay, dT is the diameter of tank and dA is the diameter of agitator. Okay. So various shape factor is for is given that where dT is the diameter of tank, dA is the diameter of agitator, L is the length of agitator blade, W is the width of agitator blade, E is the clearance between agitator bottom and inside surface of vessel, J is the width of the vessel buffer, and H is the height of liquid in the vessel. So these are the parameters for the power requirements. Now next is that the effect of Froude number appears wherever vertex formation is taking place. In buffeted tank, vertex formation is not take place. That means if we are using buffers in the reaction in the vessel, so there is a avoid vertex formation. So that's why in the buffeted tank there is a no vertex formation is it taking place. Hence, for the buffer tank, NP is not function of N Froude. That means power number is buffer tank ke liye power number is not a function of Froude number, as the effect of Froude number is not appeared. So that's why here Froude number is not considered, because of in the buffer tank we are using buffers in the vessels in the tank. So it is not considerable. So in unbuffered tank and whose Reynolds number is less than 300, so vortex formation is not taking place, and hence Froude number is not effective. Reynolds number is less than 300. Okay, this condition is already we discussing. So if the Reynolds number is less than 300, that means vortex formation is not created for unbuffled vessels, either in discussing about the unbuffled vessels. Okay, but for unbuffered tank, Reynolds number is greater than 300, so vortex formation is taking place, and hence for it this case NP is function of Froude number. So that at that time power number is a function of Froude number. So relationship between power number and Froude number for unbuffered tank with Reynolds number is greater than 300, so it is given by this equations. So phi is equal to NP upon N Froude number raised to M, or phi is calling it equal to the function of N of RE S1 S2 up to SN, where phi is called power function. M is equal to the A minus log 10 of numbers of Reynolds and divide by B, where the values of A and B are dependent on shape factor. जे A अने B नी जे values है, ये कौन-कौन पर आधार रखे जे? It is depends upon the shape factor. Shape factor, which types of shape factor we are considering. Next, so A and B which is depend on the shape factor, and for the standard agitator, A and B values are available in unit operation by McCabe-Smith method. Okay, so for a various types of agitator, phi versus numbers Reynolds number curves are available in literature survey. So each curve can be used only with the specified shape factor. It means if the types of agitator is same but the shape factor are different, we cannot use the same value of phi versus Reynolds number curve. For a buffered tank and for unbuffered tank, Reynolds number it should be less than 300 and phi equal to NP. Okay, so this one is only informative graph is given there, which is power number value and N into Reynolds number value. Okay, so this is given in the literature as well as a reference. So for first curve one is six blade turbine curve, so that is dA upon VI is pi, and form of it's like figure 1.6. Now then next point is to be discussed is that scallop of agitated vessel. How we scallop the agitated vessel? As discussed in section 5.1, many new reactions are first developed or invented in laboratory scale or a pilot plant scale. Agitated vessels type reactor. Okay, that means the many reactions and many inventions is created in the laboratory or a laboratory scale or a pilot plant scale. Okay, so at that time agitated vessel type reactions. For the design of commercial scale reactor, this one is only a laboratory scale, but we have to design for a commercial applications. Okay, as commercial scale up killer. So for the design of commercial scale reactor, scale up of lab scale or a pilot plant scale reactors are required. That means कोई भी प्लांट है इन्हें हमें एक्जीक्यूट करी अने शू करवानू छे लेबोरेटरी स्केल पर थी कमर्शियल प्लांट तरफ आपणे एने एक्जीक्यूट करवू छे तो एना माटे शू जोईए छे एनू स्केलअप करवू खूब ज जरूरी छे. फॉर द स्केलअप ऑफ एजिटेटेड वेसल्स टाइप रिएक्टर फॉलोइंग गाइडलाइंस केन बी फॉलो. सो दिस गाइडलाइंस यू हैव टू फॉलो फॉर द रिएक्टर फॉर वेसल. First, homogeneous liquid phase reactions. A tip velocity of agitator in lab scale reactor and commercial scale reactor should remain same. For a homogeneous liquid phase reactions, tip velocity of agitator in a lab scale reactor and commercial scale reactor should be remain same. Okay. બંનેના જે છે બરાબર લેબ સ્કેલ રિએક્ટર અને કોમર્શિયલ રિએક્ટર છે એ બંનેના જે વેલોસિટી છે લિક્વિડ ફેઝ રિએક્શન ટીપ વેલોસિટી તો એ બંને સેમ રહેવી જોઈએ. ટીપ વેલોસિટી ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ કોન્સ્ટન્ટ, સો દેટ્સ વાય એન વન ડી એ વન ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ એન ટુ ડી એ ટુ. એન વન એન્ડ એન ટુ શું છે? So it is a RPM speed of lab scale and commercial scale agitator respectively. Okay, RPM speeds lab scale as well as commercial scale. DA1 and DA2 shun chahe? DA1 and DA2 is the diameter of lab scale and commercial scale agitator respectively. Banne mate no diameter pan same ho jhe. Next, for a liquid gas liquid reactions, there means a gas and liquid both reactions are take place in the reaction vessel, agitated vessel, or a mass transfer governed reaction power per unit volume should remain constant. Power per volume ratio remains constant. Okay, ki jya power requirement che per volume mass transfer per they constant. So that means power function is the proportion to the n raised to cube dA raised to 5, and V is proportion to dA raised to 3, where P by V is n cube dA raised to square. Okay, P and V ki value agar hum put karte hai to kya ho jayega, to that remains n cube as it is, and dA raised to 5, so remaining term is that only dA raised square, which is constant. So n1 dA1 raised to 0.66 is equal to the n2 dA2 raised to 0.66. okay, and for the slurry type reaction, if the reaction is slurry, કે જે એજિટેશન વેસલની અંદર આપણે સ્લરી ટાઈપનું જે કોઈ પણ લિક્વિડ છે અથવા તો જે મટીરિયલ છે એને હેન્ડલિંગ કરવાનું હોય અને એને એજિટેશન કરવાનું હોય, તો એવા માટે n1 da1 raised to 0.75 is equal to n2 da2 raised to 0.75 should be considering. Okay, so this one is for a scallop of agitation's vessel. So laboratory scale par thi lai ane commercial application par improvement kari shakiye chhe. Okay.